Yes, Gary. Yes, I know. I know it's awful tough to plan publicity these days. But that's what I'm paying you for, remember? Now, listen to me. I want a story about me in the papers next week or else. Yes, I got an idea. I got a wonderful idea. How about Ricky Ricardo shoots publicity agent? Okay. But look, let's see that it gets in there, eh? Thanks. Goodbye.
Ay, qué barbaridad. No sé qué es lo que pasa a la gente. Se le paga muchísimo dinero para que le hagan la publicidad a uno, no le hace nada.
What's the matter, dear?
Oh, that, Jerry. You know, when you pay somebody to do something, you expect them to do it. I practically have to do the whole thing for him.
Now, calm down. You forget your troubles at the movies.
What are we going to see?
Oh, that picture we've been trying to get to for weeks with Marilyn Monroe.
Yeah, that'll make me forget my troubles.
Yeah, well, the Mertzes will be here any minute. Hurry up.
Hurry up and what?
Get dressed.
I'm dressed? Well, honey, I've been working around the house all day long. You don't expect me to change just to go to the neighborhood movie.
Ricky, Ricardo, do you mean you'd actually go to a movie in that awful shirt and those horrible old pants?
Marilyn wouldn't mind. Besides, this is my best pair of blue jeans.
They may be your best blue jeans, but they're disgraceful. And that shirt, it looks like it came out of the rag bag.
It did. I had an awful time finding it. Must have gotten there by mistake.
That was no mistake. I'm not stepping out of this house with you in that outfit.
Oh, now look, honey. We were going to go dancing or something. I said you had a point. But who's going to see me? We're going to walk 2 blocks down to the theater, sit in a dark movie, and walk back.
Suppose we have an accident.
Ay, ay, ay.
Suppose a car hits you and you're knocked unconscious. You stretched out in those horrible old clothes. How's that going to look on the front page?
Oh, brother. Now, look, Lucy.
Are you going to change or are we staying home?
Okay, I'll change.
Thank you.
Boy, the things I do for Marilyn Monroe. What shall I wear? My tails or my tartan dinner jacket?
Just a suit and a tie, and don't be so terribly amusing. Now, go on.
Yes, ma'am.
Hi.
Hi, girl. Where's Fred?
He's coming. Are you ready?
Yeah. Ricky will take a few minutes. He's changing his clothes. Honestly, Ethel, you should see the beat-up old clothes he wanted to wear. You couldn't imagine that anybody would want to go out looking like that.
Oh, yes, I could.
I don't know how you got Ricky to change. I couldn't do a thing with Raggedy Andy.
What's the matter with these clothes? They're comfortable.
Fred, if you wanted to be comfortable, I'm surprised you didn't go in your pajamas and bathrobe.
Ah.
Oh, no.
Fred, Ricky is wearing a suit, a shirt, and a tie. Now, how are you going to feel?
Comfortable.
It's no use, Lucy. You're beating your head against a stone slob.
Ricky!
I'll be there in a minute.
Honestly, I don't know what's taking so long. I guess he's having trouble getting those old blue jeans off without breaking them.
He's really attached to those pants, isn't he?
Sometimes I think it's vice versa. You know, he doesn't hang them up in a closet. He stands them up in the corner.
Okay, I'm ready.
Come on, I'll get Mrs. Trumbull.
Just a minute. Is she going to go that way?
No, Ricky, it doesn't matter what Fred does. Come on.
Well, come on, little Lord Fauntleroy.
That does it.
Now, Ricky.
Nobody's going to come a little front of Rui.
Oh.